In this video, we're going to compare Figma Make with Lovable. We're going to do three different use cases, and at the end, I'll give you my final decision on which tool I would use for different use cases. So the first use case I'm asking it to do is to design an onboarding experience. And what's cool about this video is you're going to see the real results that each tool is able to build. And I'm going to quickly edit it so you can see this in as short of a time as possible. So here on the left side, I have Figma Make. Figma Make is Figma's AI design tool. It's a little separate from Figma. So it's not designing Figma files, but it's designing designs and things like that using AI, very similar to how Lovable would do. So here we have our first onboarding screen that we created. And let me just pull this out so we can see what it looks like. I like what it did here, and it created these onboarding screens, and I can keep clicking through just to see what it did. It came up with four or five screens here, and then I can click sign up or sign in. So that's just the onboarding screens that it created. I didn't give it much of a prompt. I like to see how these tools do with just not much of a prompt at all. And then here what it says, next steps, add user authentication, integrate location services, or create a main app dashboard. Why don't I say create a main app dashboard with ride booking, and let's see how it does. And then let's go back over to Lovable, and it looks like Lovable finished its onboarding as well. So here we go. Welcome to rideshare. Next, next, and get started. And then that's it. I feel like Figma did a little bit of a better job making it look more like an app with basically some of these mobile elements like this back button, for example. Whereas Lovable, I think, did a more polished job overall. Now, I think that the reason for this is Figma is trained a little bit more, just the AI is a little bit better at building. When I asked for kind of an onboarding app like Uber, it knew that was a mobile app. Whereas I think with Lovable, it's more building web apps. So that's the difference there. And I think why we see some of those like mobile elements on the Figma Make. So let's just see what Figma is able to come up with this second prompt here. I'm just curious, but I think that's something that's really helpful to know the difference here is Lovable is going to design more of a web-based design off the bat, as opposed to Figma, which if you ask for an app, will design more of an app interface. One thing that you should know is that Lovable is able to add a backend database and actually build a fully functional app, whereas with Figma, you are really just building designs. So just keep that in mind. These are different tools, but in this test, we're really focusing more on the design aspect of each of these tools. Okay, so we now have our version 2, which it says it completed the full homepage. So let's go through onboarding. I wonder if I click skip, if it'll get through. Then if I click sign up, it'll just bring me to that homepage. Now, of course, it doesn't have a real image here, but it put that in as a mockup. So really think of Figma Make as a tool for mockups. And yeah, we have the ability to build out this full mockup. Yeah, overall, I am really impressed here with the mockup capability of Figma Make here. The next test that we're going to do is a shopping web app mockup for selling cars. In this test, I want to do a web app mockup because in the last test, we did an iOS or a mobile app mockup. And in that case, I think that Figma did a better job. But in this case, let's see how Lovable does when we give it a web app mockup. And again, in this video, we're going to really be testing the web design functionality as opposed to Lovable, which can go to the next step of adding a backend database, things like that. Check out some of our other videos on how to actually do that. But in this video, I want us to come away with a decision on which is better for the design aspect. Now, Figma has built its reputation on design, so I'm expecting Figma to win this out, but I'll be really curious to see what happens after this and then after the last test that we do. So both of these designs are finished. First, let's take a look at Figma Make. So it did a really good job, I think, at building out this marketplace mockup. It even got images of cars. I'm wondering if it got them from Unsplash or something, because yeah, it doesn't look like AI generated images because they think they're real cars. I could be wrong about that, but although it's definitely not matching the car to the image, which I think makes sense for a mockup. But pretty cool. Let's see if it has different pages. It doesn't look like it. It just has this one page, but it also has filtering, which seems to work. It has different views as well, which is pretty cool. And yeah, the filtering like actually does work. So that all is pretty impressive. So let's jump over to Lovable. So it looks like what Lovable did was create kind of this homepage, which is nice because Figma Make only created like the search page essentially. So it designed out what a homepage could look like. Here we go. It also has images of cars. I think the images that Lovable did are definitely AI generated because that is not a real car. But then I go to sell. It looks like there's no like full page of cars here for Lovable. Whereas with Make, it has like the whole search functionality for the marketplace. So again, I'm going to give the design edge here to Figma versus Lovable. Of course, Lovable, again, I could take this and start building out a real marketplace, adding a backend, which with Figma, I can't. But overall, I actually do prefer the design mockup capabilities of Figma Make. We're going to do one last test here, which is a mockup of a pizza restaurant website. And again, we're going to do these head to head and we'll see what the result is. All right, so both designs are finished. Let's start with Figma Make. And we have a nice little header here. Just a little issue here with the view button, menu button, not visible until I hover, but we have add to cart for different items, view full menu, story. I actually really like this for a restaurant website. It's very simple. It has everything that you need. And I think for a mockup, really good. I like it. So here we are on Lovable. So we have a kind of similar header section, similar add to order, view menu, story, visit. Actually very similar with both of these. Let's go back to Figma. Yeah, really similar. One thing I'll say is that like Lovable sites seem to have this feel that it was generated by Lovable. The more you build with Lovable, you get a sense of that. The other thing is I see Lovable does use AI generated images. I wish I had the ability to turn that on and off. I actually don't love that. I like how Figma, they must be getting these images from Unsplash or something like that. See if I copy image address. Yeah, I can see that it is coming from Unsplash. And I actually prefer that when possible because I just think the images are better. Yeah, okay, so we've done three examples, an iOS app, a web app, and a website. I will say for design, I prefer Figma. Now, if I wanted to take these to a full website or a full app with a backend, then I would go with Lovable. So just keep that in mind. Before design, after the three examples, I would choose Figma Make. I hope that you enjoyed this video. Leave a comment below. Let me know what you think, which one you think is better. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to get more free content like this, and we'll see you in the next video.